Let us discuss a situation where we treat metal wires or rod as equivalent springs. Like if we are having a metal rod which is clamped at one end, say it is of length L, and the rod is pulled in outward direction by an external force F, and due to elasticity, say the rod is elongated by a distance x. So in this situation, we can see the strain produced here will be x by L, and if cross sectional area of rod is A, then stress due to which the resulting strain is produced can be written as F by A if at this position the rod is in equilibrium. And according to the definition of Young modulus, we can write Y is equals to F by A upon x by L. And here we rearrange the expression, will get the external force which is balancing the internal restoring forces. This F can be written as YA by L multiplied by X. Here YA and L are constant, which can be written as KX. Or we can say in this situation, the restoring force is proportional to the deformation length, which happens generally in case of a spring, and if we treat this rod with an equivalent force constant K, then it can be treated like a spring. So in this situation, the equivalent force constant for rod can be taken as, this equivalent force constant is YA by L. The same thing we'll discuss again in coming sections when we'll talk about the energy stored in elasticity. Or due to elasticity of a material, there also we'll discuss a similar concept. But right now here, we should limit ourselves up to the situation when we can say whenever there are metal wires or rods are there, these can be treated like an equivalent spring having force constant equals to the product of Young modulus and the cross-sectional area divided by the initial or unstretched or unstressed length of the wire. So it can be treated like a spring. And similar to that, we can also analyze about spring combinations when some springs are combined. Then also we can find out the equivalent constant. Let's discuss on the next sheet about the same. Say in continuation, if we talk about a situation like say we are given with a system when there is a rod having length L1. And which is having its cross-sectional area A1. It is connected in series with another rod which is of length L2 and its cross-sectional area is A2. And at the bottom on a hook, say a weight of mass M is hanged. And in this situation, we are required to find the total extension or the total distance x by which the elongation will be there in the two rods. Then we can simply treat the system like two springs connected in series, like one is having a force constant K1 and other is having a force constant K2, and through which a block of mass M is hanged. In this situation, we can state the equivalent force constant for such a system can be written as K equivalent, and the value is K1 K2 by K1 plus K2, which you already studied in laws of motion. And here if the equivalent spring constant is this, then the deforming force or the elongation force acting on it will be the only weight of the block. And the restoring force in equilibrium position can be written as K equivalent into X. If it is elongated by X, so we can simply write K equivalent into X is equals to Mg. And the elongation X can be written as Mg by K equivalent. And here the K equivalent, that is the equivalent force constant for the series combination of these two springs is obtained by this expression. And individual force constant K1, K2 we are already having, like we can write K1 as Y1 A1 by L1 and K2 as Y2 A2 by L2, which we have just now discussed in the previous sheet. That for any rod having Young modulus Y1 length L1 and cross-sectional area A1, its equivalent force constant spring can be written as YA by L. Similarly, for the second we are writing. So, this system can be taken as equivalent system for two springs connected in series. So, substituting K1, K2 here and K equivalent here will get the value of total elongation in such cases. Similarly, when rods are connected side by side or in parallel, we can apply the case of parallel combination of springs where I hope you can recall the equivalent force constant can be given by some of the individual force constants if the springs are connected in parallel. Then also we can analyze in the similar way. You just need to replace each rod or a wire by an equivalent spring, and correspondingly we need to solve the situation like this.